Good morning, dear students. We are looking for the topic is matter around us here, and we are talking about subtopic that is concentration of solution. So in yesterday's lecture, we have seen everything related to the concentration of solution. But today we are going to see how to measure or what are the standard units to measure the concentration of solution. So first of all, yesterday we have seen the concentration.
Very small particles dissolved
as WP, means weight of solution, weight of solute plus weight of solvent into 100. In this manner, we will get an idea or we can find out the concentration of solute by the mass by mass percentage. Do you understand, children? See, there are some numerals. These numerals we will see at the end of the lesson. Okay? So, whatever the theoretical part is there or whatever the formulas are there to find out the concentration of solution we will see, and at the end of the lesson we will see few examples based on this formulas. Understood? So, this is mass by mass percentage. How can we find out mass by mass percentage? We have given for solute we will denote it by A, and B we will denote by the solvent. Okay? So, A plus B will make our solution. A plus B will make our solution. Okay, students? So, at the numerator what would come? Weight of solute, which will be denoted by WA. Then, weight of solution. Weight of solution means weight of solute plus weight of solvent into 100, as we are finding out the percentage. Understood? So we will get an answer through this. So numerals will be there or some numerical problems will be there. Those problems we will see and are at the end of the lesson when we will solve the exercise of this lesson. Okay? Now we go for the second expression of concentration of solution, that is mass by volume percentage. It will be same like mass by mass percentage only. But in first case, in mass by mass percentage, we have taken the mass of solute and mass of solvent into the grams or kilograms. We can take it into the grams and kilograms. So that it was said as a mass by mass percentage. Means both the terms we have taken in the form of grams or kilograms. But the difference here is that solute is taken in the form of gram and solvent is taken in the form of liquid, and so that it will come as a mass by volume percentage. Okay, mass by volume. This here what will happen? The mass of solute upon volume of solution. Do you understand? In the percent it will come. Means mass of solute here it will come. Whatever the mass of solute will be there, that will come. As well as volume of solution. Means the mass of solute will be in the gram and total mass of solution will be in the liter or milliliter into 100. Understood, students? So this is the second type, that is mass by volume percentage. So whenever we will solve some problems, numerical problems related to
strength of solution. Strength means concentration only. We have seen
a solution. Did you get student? Strength of solution can be find out or can be defined as that amount of solute is present, amount of solute is present, is present in gram in 1 liter of solution. Okay, means amount of solute is present into the gram. Here we have seen mass by volume. Okay, so in mass by volume we have seen mass upon volume into 100. So here we are going to see only mass of solute upon volume of solution, but we are not going to find out the percentage. Percentage sign is not there, and we are not going to find out the percentage over here. So this is just the ratio. That was the percentage we find out, mass by volume. In that we have seen, we have tried to find out the percentage of solute here, but here only the ratio of mass of solute and volume of solution we are going to see. Understood, students? So here are four types we have seen today, that is mass by mass percentage, then volume by volume percentage, then mass by volume percentage, and lastly we have seen that is strength of solution, which is denoted by gram per liter. Means strength of solution is defined as the amount of solute in 1 liter of a solution. This is just a ratio, that is mass of solute upon volume of solution. There will be no 100 because this is a ratio, but there we have seen mass by volume, that was the percentage. Okay students, so now we will go. So related, whatever the things which were related to the solution are completed now. So now we will go for the next topic of this lesson, that is suspension. See, we have completed related to solution everything, and then my first lecture when I said you that the mixtures are of two types, homogeneous mixture and heterogeneous mixture. So solution is one kind of homogeneous mixture we have seen, and there are two types of heterogeneous mixtures. Those are suspensions and colloidal solution. So our today's topic is suspension. What is meant by suspension? So suspension is actually a heterogeneous mixture of solid and liquid. It's a heterogeneous mixture. Suspension is not a homogeneous mixture. You can go back and see my first video. In that I have given you the differentiation of homogeneous mixture and heterogeneous mixture. So in my previous lecture it will be clearer for you what is meant by heterogeneous mixture. So suspension is one kind of heterogeneous mixture in which solute particles can be easily seen with the help of our naked eyes into the solution. Okay, so suspension is a heterogeneous mixture. Heterogeneous mixture means solute and solvent particles are not in a same state, are not in a same phase, both are in a different phase. So we can easily separate also. So suspension is what a heterogeneous mixture. Okay, so whenever something is we can see into the water, we easily say if this is suspended into the water. Suspended into the water, why we can say? Because we can easily see to it. Understood? And we can easily suspensions. It is heterogeneous mixture. What is the first property? It is heterogeneous mixture. Means solute and solvent particles are in different phase. This is non-uniform solution. Okay, we have seen the heterogeneous mixture. Okay, second is the particles of solute can be easily seen by the naked eye. The particles of solute can be, these are too weak to see by our naked eyes. Okay, so second property, the particles, the solute particles can be easily seen by naked eyes because solute particles are too weak to see with our naked eyes. Third property is that as we can see them with our naked eyes, means they scatter the beam of light. See, in solution, in properties of solution we have seen, if once the solute particles we try to add into the water, the solute particles are completely soluble because these are too small to occupy the space between the water molecule. But these particles are too large that cannot be occupied the space between the water molecules. Means they scatter the beam of light and makes the path visible. Okay, so the third property is they scatter the beam of light, the beam of light, and can be seen easily and makes path visible. Means whenever the light particle falls on the suspended particles, the suspended particles can be easily seen. Okay, so that is they scatter the beam of light. Okay, and the fourth property is that simple filtration, simple physical